On June 6, 1912, the largest volcanic eruption of the 20th century began. As the volcano dramatically exploded in remote Alaska, pyroclastic flows raced across the landscape, burying everything in a vast amount of superheated rock. These pyroclastic flows were unusually energetic, traveling beyond 19 miles or 30 kilometers distant. As the powerful eruption continued for a period of 72 hours, particles of ash carried high into the atmosphere were deposited as far away as Seattle and Washington State. For several decades, the eruption just described was believed to have originated from the Katmai volcano. After all, the caldera you see on its edifice formed during the eruption, and it was covered in volcanic ash. Yet, further research revealed that Katmai, despite being active, did not produce the aforementioned eruption despite the formation of a large caldera on the same date. So, how was this possible? Which volcano produced the major eruption? This video will answer these two questions and discuss this active stratovolcano. Mount Katmai can be found in southwest Alaska, where it is 67 miles east-southeast of the town of King Salmon. It is one of a number of several closely spaced volcanoes which are located in the scenic Katmai National Park. Mount Katmai began forming 70,000 years ago when a volume of andesite magma erupted onto the surface. This initial eruption was unusually explosive as the magma feeding the eruption contained an abundance of combustible gas. As a result, energetic volcanic explosions occurred, ejecting bombs of lava in a several mile radius which occurred alongside pyroclastic flows. By the end of this eruption, a small gray volcanic cone had been constructed. Additional eruptions later continued to build this volcanic cone, which started on a raised ridge at an initial height of 770 meters or 2,526 feet. After tens of thousands of years of eruptions, two large volcanic cones separated by a distance of 1 mile had been constructed. The peak to the south was 7,500 feet tall, while the peak to the north had a height of 7,360 feet. Over time, the underlying magma chamber below Katmai became more silica-rich, which in turn caused the nature of eruptions to change. Instead of producing frequent andesitic eruptions, Katmai would now produce infrequent, large explosive eruptions in a manner similar to Mount Pinatubo in the Philippines or El Chichon in Mexico. One such massive eruption occurred 22,500 years ago, which ejected 35 cubic kilometers of ash and volcanic rock. Much of this ash fell on Kodiak Island to the east. This massive eruption buried some areas in as much as 50 meters or 164 feet of superheated rock. After a long period of dormancy, another explosive eruption occurred 16,000 years ago, but was an order of magnitude smaller. This eruption likely had a volcanic explosivity index of a 5 and ejected several meters of dacite composition ash in a several mile radius. Then, Katmai became dormant once again. Finally, on June 6, 1912, a large volcanic eruption began. 10 kilometers to the west of Mount Katmai, the first eruption from a new volcano emerged from the valley floor. Over the span of 72 hours, this new volcano known as Novarupta ejected 31 cubic kilometers worth of volcanic rock. This rock buried a vast area in superheated ash which would take decades to cool and is now known as the Valley of 10,000 Smokes. Strangely, this new volcano used a massive amount of magma directly from Katmai's magma chamber. Thus, although Katmai did not initially erupt, a caldera collapse occurred as its magma was drained away. Its towering 7,500-foot-tall peak dropped to a height of 6,700 feet, while the newly formed caldera was 4,000 feet deep. This collapse also triggered a minor explosive lava dome-forming eruption within the newly formed caldera, which constructed two small lava domes. By July 21st, the eruption had ended and this volcano has never erupted since. Mount Katmai is one of those volcanoes that if it were to erupt again would solely be through a major explosive eruption. Although no nearby settlements are in the direct path of any pyroclastic flows if it were to erupt again, any tourists in this remote national park would be placed in danger. As a result of these hazards, the US Geological Survey designated Katmai as a high-threat volcano. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.